And back to the campaign. This election story is from the battleground state of Pennsylvania. Ray Suarez has our report.
Because you used to work on the polls, too.
60-year-old Wailola Lee of Philadelphia says she's voted in almost every presidential election since the 70s. She's a retired employee of the city's Board of Education who spent several years working at her local polling station. But in November, under the voter identification law passed in Pennsylvania, Lee may not be able to cast a ballot. The new law requires all eligible voters to have a state-approved form of identification issued by PennDOT, the Pennsylvania Department of Transportation, and the requirements for approval are strict. Wailola Lee already has a number of identification cards.
This is the only ID that I really have to identify myself, and it's the Social Security card. Then I have a personal Pennsylvania ID card.
But Lee does not have one document required by the law to get a state-issued ID, her original birth certificate. It was destroyed in a fire.
I've been trying to get my birth certificate for the past 10 years, over 10 years. So I did send it to Georgia, where I was born at, in order to obtain a birth certificate. But they sent me a delayed birth certificate without a seal on it. And come to find out, it's just only an application.
Lee is not alone. The state's most recent numbers show more than 750,000 registered voters in Pennsylvania lack the identification required to vote under the new law.
When the Pennsylvania legislature passed what critics and supporters alike call one of the toughest photo voter ID laws in the country, it set off a ferocious debate. There are some who say that this is really a law in search of a crime, while others say it's doing nothing less than protecting the integrity of every election here.
Representative Daryl Metcalf is the sponsor of the voter ID law, House Bill 934.
This doesn't disenfranchise anybody. And I think it should be insulting to any American to say that you might be disenfranchised because you don't have the ability to get a photo ID. It's a legislation I've been working on for about the last 10 years to ensure that we have this very common sense policy in place so that when one shows up to vote, they prove that they are who they claim to be.
But the state has stipulated that there are no documented cases of fraud at the polls in Pennsylvania. Yesterday, the Civil Rights Division of the Justice Department opened an investigation into the law to determine whether it complies with the Voting Rights Act. And four civil rights groups are challenging the voter ID law in Pennsylvania's Commonwealth Court. In hearings beginning tomorrow, the groups will seek a temporary injunction to the law, arguing it will disenfranchise specific groups of voters who are not likely to have acceptable identification, among them minorities, seniors, and the urban poor. David Gersh of the Washington, D.C. law firm Arnold & Porter is one of the attorneys arguing the case on behalf of the plaintiffs, including Wailola Lee.
There's no plan for getting hundreds of thousands of people the proper ID. They can say it's available, but they have no plan for actually accomplishing that.
Gersh and his team will allege the law is a partisan effort to suppress Democratic votes. As evidence, they will introduce comments by Republican House Leader Mike Terzai. In a recent speech to the state's Republican committee, Terzai added the voter ID law to a checklist of Republican victories.
Voter ID, which is going to allow Governor Romney to win the state of Pennsylvania. Done.
33 states have passed laws requiring ID for voting. Of these, only five, Pennsylvania, Indiana, Kansas, Tennessee, and Georgia, have strict photo ID requirements. In all five of these states, the laws were Republican-led initiatives. In Pennsylvania, opponents and supporters of the law are mounting a vigorous campaign to educate voters before Election Day and pressure public officials to relax the identification requirements. Last week, state officials announced a plan to offer free identification cards to every one of these voters in time for Election Day, as long as they can provide a birth date, Social Security number, and two proofs of residency. But these cards will not be available until the end of August, and details of how they will be rolled out remain unclear. Carol Achill is Secretary of the Commonwealth and a spokesperson for the law.
People on the other side of the question have maintained that this is really a regulation in search of an infraction or a prevention in search of a crime. How do you respond to that?
I think people say, what's the big deal about showing an ID? I have to show ID to buy cough medicine over the counter.
When we come back, we can get that.
Okay.
All right.
Joe Sertain is the president of the Pennsylvania Voter ID Coalition, part of a nonpartisan government watchdog group called the Committee of 70. The coalition is leading an effort to educate voters on the new law, and Sertain says it's no easy task.
There are all kinds of problems associated with the implementation of this law that was not considered by the legislature when they drafted the law and when it was signed by Governor Corbett. We are trying to do what we can across the Commonwealth, but starting here in Pennsylvania, in Philadelphia, to make sure that those people get the assistance that they need in order to be able to comply with the law, regardless of our feelings about the law.
Voter rights advocates say they're not opposed to a law requiring identification to vote. It's the complexity of the Pennsylvania law they object to. For some voters, they say, acquiring the right identification is not as simple as a visit to the PennDOT Center. A study by the nonpartisan Brennan Center found nearly 500,000 eligible voters in 10 states with strict voter ID laws live in households without vehicles and reside at least 10 miles from an office that issues ID more than 2 days a week. In an effort to educate voters on the new law, Pennsylvania has launched a $5 million outreach campaign.
We think we're up to the task, and we're aiming to make sure that all 8.2 registered voters in Pennsylvania have photo ID.
But voting rights advocates say they're frantically racing to reach every at-risk voter in the short run-up to Election Day. They're also trying to coordinate efforts for voters like Wailola Lee, who's still trying to get a valid voter ID card.
If I don't get the birth certificate to get the proper photo ID, I won't be able to vote.
No matter what happens in court tomorrow, one side or the other will almost certainly appeal. And President Obama and Mitt Romney's campaigns will be prepared with legions of lawyers on standby if Pennsylvania ends up being a close contest on November 6th.
In this week's political checklist, Ray talked about what he saw in the battleground state with the NewsHour's political editor, Christina Bellantoni. That's on our politics page.